Hello and welcome to What in the World. This is a regular show where geo-Googlers dip into interesting enterprise maps related topics and share the results with you. I'm Dylan Thomas. I'm a geo-enterprise community manager, and joining me today is Ryan Thomas, who works with our enterprise customers on getting up and running with our geo products. Hi, Ryan.
Hi, Dylan. How are you?
I'm good. I'm looking forward to the show today. You are going to be talking with us about Google Maps Engine and, more to the point, how to get GME layers up and running and visible in the Google Maps JavaScript API, right?
That's right. Specifically, I'm going to be talking about Maps Engine Layer and Dynamic Maps Engine Layer. And because that's been such a tongue twister for me, I'm going to refer to it as MEL and DMEL during the presentation.
That's an awesome idea.
All right, let's take it away and we'll look at a presentation that we have today. All right, so this is what we're going to go through today. We're going to talk about what are MEL and DMEL, why they were created, what are the benefits to the users, go over a little bit more information, and then do a quick demonstration on how to use them. So what are MEL and DMEL? Well, Google has the excellent location data hosting service of Google Maps Engine, which you're probably familiar about, where you can upload your map data, style, and store your data in the cloud. Google also has the map making tool JavaScript API. And MEL and DMEL are essentially the link between them. Now, using those, you can easily put a map on your website that shows your GME content. So why were they created? MEL and DMEL were originally created because there wasn't a concise and simple way to put style GME data on a non-GME map, an example of Maps API. Since customers went through the effort to style their data on GME, they didn't want to have to repeat the effort in the Maps API JavaScript. So enter MEL and DMEL. The MEL was created to make it easy to visualize your content on a map. And prior to MEL, the only way to add GME content was to draw it one feature at a time, which, as you can imagine, can become pretty cumbersome and time-consuming. DMEL was created to make the experience for your end user much richer, and you can add styling changes which reacts to the user, such as mouse over, which we'll see later on during the demonstration. So what are the benefits to users? Essentially, this is a powerful integration between our geo products of Google Maps Engine and JavaScript API. And it's a simple and easy way to visualize your GME data on a map. And what's nice about it is there's little to no experience or coding experience necessary for users. This is all accomplished in approximately 3 lines of code, which is very simple. And just giving a little bit more information, this does not work with Internet Explorer 8 or earlier versions, so that's just something to be aware of. And these are several links with documentation on Maps Engine Layer, Dynamic Maps Engine Layer, and then OAuth to Playground. And these links will be embedded within the video for you to go to at your leisure as you come across any issues or questions. So let's move into the demonstration. As you can see right now, I am in Google Maps Engine. And let's say we created a layer in Google Maps Engine and the data was about the 2010 census. Now, if we go over to the right, we can click on this map to view a draft of our data in GME. And as I zoom in, zoom out and then zoom in, we can see the data or the layer that was placed upon the map here in GME. Now if we click on the map, we can get some information from the layer that we've added. So now we want to get this layer and place this on a map on a website. So the thing that you want to do is go to the upper right hand corner, and you can see this button in the upper right hand corner that says Access Links. And if you click on that, you have the asset ID, which is the same as the layer ID. Now you can copy this layer ID, and then from here we'll move into some actual script that we have already filled out. And now that we're in the script, you can see there's a place for the layer ID, and this is where you would place the layer ID that we just copied and pasted from Google Maps Engine. And as we scroll down, now this is a little bit more complicated than it normally would be, because in the demonstration I'm going to be showing two maps side by side, but it's really only a few lines of code. And you can see we have the DML code here, and then just below that we have the MEL code.
Oh, so that looks really simple, Ryan. All you're doing is calling each of those classes, and you're just passing in the layer ID you got and then linking it to one or other of the maps, right? That's it.
Exactly. So now that we've looked at the script, let's go and take a look at what the maps will look like. Okay, these are the two maps that we're now displaying. Now the map on the left is from Maps Engine layer and is a static map. The map to the right is from Dynamic Maps Engine layer, and it's more dynamic and interactive. So let's zoom in on the map on the left. And we're headed toward Kansas. Now let's just scroll over our data and see, we can click on it and still get the same information that was in Google Maps Engine. Now let's go over to the map on the right and zoom in back to Kansas. Now this time this map is a little bit more dynamic and it has a mouse over effect. So as you can see, as we scroll over some of the data in the layer, it'll light up. And so this is just a very simple example of ways to make your maps more interactive for your users and make it a richer experience for them.
So the key difference here, as I understand it then, is your Maps Engine layer, or MEL, as we've just renamed it, is on the left, and that's really getting traditional map tiles as images that have been created in Maps Engine, right? So that we're downloading map tiles and displaying them, and that's why you have to click on a feature to go get the feature information on the left. But on the right, we're actually streaming the vectors from the Maps Engine layer, and that's why when they're down on the client, we have more of this interactivity.
Exactly right. And this is what MEL and DML can do for you by taking the Google Maps Engine data and displaying them for you with the JavaScript API.
Got it. So it looks like, and when you're hovering there, I saw the change of color. So obviously you can listen to events with dynamic Maps Engine layer, like mouse over or on click, obviously, and change an individual feature as well.
That's right.
Well, thanks for showing that, Ryan. I do have a couple of follow-on questions. This is, after all, the enterprise folks who are listening in. So one of the things I wanted to ask was about authentication and authorization. I know that OAuth2 is the protocol we use to provide authorization for map layers so that access control data isn't just wide open to the internet. Are there some resources available or a place a customer can go to learn more about that?
There are, and that's a really good question, which a lot of people have. In the links that I showed earlier in the presentation, there was a link to an example in the developer's page where it will have a JavaScript example about OAuth2, and another link is for the OAuth2 playground where you can go and learn more about OAuth2 and how to utilize it. And if you have additional questions, feel more than welcome to get in touch with us through the community to help answer any specific questions you may have.
Good point. Thanks for plugging the community there, Ryan. That's pretty nice. So the two pieces you mentioned there is the OAuth2 or the OAuth playground, where you can learn more about OAuth just as a base protocol and approach to doing this. And the second part is a specific example for Maps Engine, right?
Exactly.
Got it. One other thing I was thinking about as you were hovering over the map feature there is you're changing the color, but there's no reason you couldn't just call any kind of code at that point, right? You hover over a feature and you could show a picture or go get some Wikipedia data about that county in Kansas. I know that a lot of customers on the dynamic maps engine layer also want to then go and query the Google Maps engine via the API as well. Are there any limitations that they should think about as they're streaming these vectors down to the client using the Maps API and then querying back to the feature in Maps Engine?
That's a good point. The possibilities are pretty great on what you can do with that, but people should just be aware that the limit is 1,000 features. And so going over that, you may run into some issues.
Oh, so you're saying that there's no limitation on the number of things that Maps API could display, at least today, in terms of, you know, we're not going to say a million, that may be too many, right? But the GME API itself is what's used to make this thing work, and that has a limitation today of 1,000 features per request, right?
Exactly. As long as that doesn't go up, GME is essentially doing the heavy lifting, and so 1,000 features in GME is the limit as of today.
Got it. Okay. All right, well, Ryan, I want to really thank you for taking the time to show us some tips and tricks there on MEL and DMEL today. And so thank you. And we'll make sure that this video is available online for those of you who couldn't watch it live. And we'll include the links. And I want to reiterate Ryan's offer to help in the community. So if you do have further questions, just get in touch with us and let us know. Thanks very much.